handed to me. When I was 22 years old, I raised my right hand and I took an oath as an ensign to uphold this Constitution and protect it against all enemies, foreign and domestic. And I bonded that oath not only with my God, but we promised our soul. In the military, when we take that oath, we pledge our life. And I almost had the misfortune, you know, to get called on that. The Constitution is the foundation of America. It isn't Republican, it isn't Democrat. But it's the foundation that allows us to get on either side of an issue and argue and debate and argue, and agree or disagree, or agree to disagree, without repercussion, without retaliation. What's happening today, the Constitution is under direct assault in all branches of the government. The judiciary, Ginsburg took an oath to uphold the Constitution, protect it, honor it. I mean, it's why the Supreme Court is there. And now she has issues with it. Well, my issue with her is if she has an issue with the Constitution, it's very easy to resolve. You resign.
That's right.
The other thing that I find very disturbing is federal judges legislating from the bench. Legislation is reserved for the sovereigns in our republic, and we delegate that authority to, you know, both houses of Congress. That's got to stop. Under the Constitution, we have the authority of impeachment, and I think it's probably time we dust this off and look how we impeach judges that decide they want to take from the legislative branch. We also have transgressions in the legislative branch. The NDAA legislation that came out that was supported by everybody in Congress save six has given the president authority which no man in this land should have. He can send the military to your house any time of the day, pick you up, and detain you indefinitely without a warrant, without access to an attorney, basically suspending your habeas corpus. You could end up in Gitmo. The executive branch has also, pretty much since World War II, more notably started around Vietnam, we started getting in the habit of going to war without a declaration from Congress. This is very dangerous. What it starts doing is shifting the authority from the sovereign, the people behind me, which they delegated to Congress, and which Congress has that authority to declare war. Well, when Leon Panetta can get in front of Congress and very smugly say, we don't need your authority, we can get it from the UN, well, the Secretary of Defense doesn't answer to the UN. He may think he does, but he answers to these people, he answers to these folks behind me through their representative government. And what's really disturbing is our representatives here in the state of Maine stand by quietly, which to me means that they agree with what's going on. I do not. I am a proven leader. I have the ability to get down there and debate and argue and brief the positions of the state of Maine in a way that I feel will be able to prevail. And it isn't only with getting the Constitution back on track. We're totally broke. We have to stop. We have to stop what we're doing with this country. I'm looking at people in front of me right now filming this. We have stolen their future. We have stolen their economic future. We've stolen our children's future. We have stolen our grandchildren's future. It has to stop. Yeah. As my introduction said, I worked up in the nosebleed section of the government. About 20 years ago, when the Chief of Naval Operations, Michael Borda, committed suicide, the Navy went out and reviewed the records of their 3,800 or so captains and selected 100 of us to teach leadership. And I have to tell you, I was flattered. I was a young captain. I made captain after the Persian Gulf War. And they picked me with the others to teach leadership to all our commissioned officers. And one of the things that we really pushed was accountability and responsibility. We're accountable as individuals. As individuals, we have responsibility. And I feel it's my responsibility because of the oath I took of the Constitution to preserve it, to protect it. And I would like to hold the people that we have in government today that aren't upholding their oath, I want to hold them accountable. I'm not quite sure how we do that yet, but I've got a pretty good idea we can do it at the ballot box. Because the most valuable thing we have as a sovereign is our vote. And I don't know about everybody else, but I want my country back.
Amen.
I'm tired of dynastic rule in Washington. I think there should be 3 terms to the House, 2 terms to the Senate, and then you go home. What happens down in Washington, familiarity breeds contempt. And they forget that they're serving the people back home. You know, Americans need to unite. Independents, Republicans, Democrats. They're after all of us, people. This new world order, we won't be citizens, we won't be sovereigns, we'll be subjects. So we have a golden opportunity this election to make a choice to send an individual down there and send this gentleman behind me down there that will help you take back this country. God bless America. God bless all of you. Thank you.